Sports Gaming Universe.
Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Derek Jeter Player Lock Series season mode here in MLB 14, the show. Derek Jeter is retiring after this year, so we're sending him off here with a player lock season mode series following the last run through the league and comparing it to what he does in real life here. So as we are looking at the end of April here, what are we, just about a day ahead of the actual schedule? And you look at where the Yankees stand, 10-12, 4.5 games back. Got some work to do here, but we're going to start that off by taking on the Angels here at Yankee Stadium. So we'll get a taste of the AL West today. They are a game below 500, so both teams with something to prove and improve here as Jeter comes to the plate, looking to start his day at the plate off right and get the Yankees jump started. So Ellsbury's been retired. There's one out, and this is going to be a seeing-high base hit through the infield there, the first baseman and second baseman. It squirts right between both of them, and Jeter is on first with a single. Let's look at the replay here. He didn't hit it hard, but he placed it perfectly there under the glove of the second baseman, diving for it. And that's out to right field for a base hit. So in the fourth, it's still no score, and Jeter's giving this a ride to right field. And he hit it to the fence, but it is caught right there. Had a bid to go over the short porch in right field and put the Yankees up 1-0, but it's not to be. Here we are in the top of the fifth and still no score. This is going to be to Jeter, starting a double play, and it is a double play. They turn it nicely. And these two teams still struggling to get a run home. We're in the top of the sixth now. Another double play opportunity. Yeah, there it is. Jeter gets it started. And another double play in the books. The Angels cut down two just like that. And still we have no score. Kuroda pitching a nice game. And Jeter helping out on the defense here. Top of the seventh. 3-2 count. We have another one. Jeter's going to cover the bag. Can he turn it? Yes. Three innings in a row, we've turned a double play and kept the Angels off the scoreboard. Kuroda, once again, working it and let the defense do the work for him. Easy double play balls there, really, as he was the one to start that one. Jeter now 1-for-2. He had that single in the first, but there have not been very many hits to go around for the Yankees at all. We'll see if he can add to that total and maybe get something jump-started. Bottom of the seventh. We've had the seventh inning stretch. He finds a pitch he likes, and he hits this to right center. That could go to the fence. He should have a double here, and that is exactly what he'll have. Settles it. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Put on the brakes there. Thought about going to third base, but he thinks better of it. The captain's got a double, and maybe he's leading the Yankees to the score they need to get ahead here today, as we are still scoreless in the bottom of the seventh. Pitch in duel for sure, but Jeter gets a hold of this one, and so now I think they only have four hits on the game and two belong to Jeter. That's a good job right there, but now he's got to get around. This is going to be a base hit to left, and there's no way they're going to send him there. Nope, no shot. So the throw comes in, and oh, catcher has a little bit of problem with it, but now you've got first and third and the best chance to push a run home today. This is going to be a ground ball, double play ball. Oh, whoa, it takes him off the bag at second and safe at first. Everyone's safe. Jeter scores. How did they mess this play up so badly? You saw all the double plays we were turning, but let's take a look at what the Angels do wrong here. This throw completely takes him off the bag to the center field side. He tries to regroup and get an out. Nope, Teixeira beats that out. The Yankees end up scoring three runs in the inning. They give one up in the ninth, but win the game 3-1. Kuroda gets the win, and we take 2 of 3 in that series against the Angels. And now, Seattle's coming to town. It'll be Sabathia versus King Felix. What a matchup here. We had to play that one. So Jeter and the rest of the Bronx Bombers will be trying to hit against Felix Hernandez today, which is no small task. And look at here, a homecoming of sorts for Robinson Cano. How is the fan response? It's mixed. He went and took big time money in Seattle. What did he want? Upwards of $300 million? And he didn't get that, but he obviously was not going to get the offer he wanted from the Yankees. And he went on out to Seattle. So his first at-bat back at Yankee Stadium, and he's going to ground out to Jeter there, who will throw him out. So welcome back, Robinson Cano, but I think they would rather see the Yankees win the game here than see you have a good game. I'm just have a hunch there. So Sabathia gets through his half of the first with no problem. We're in the second now, two runners on, and I believe that is Cano again. He is going to ground into the fielder's choice. Close play at second, but Jeter gets him with the throw by a hair. Still no score going into the second. We're seeing some low-scoring ball games in this episode. 1-0 Yankees now, and that is going to be a caught stealing. As a matter of fact, that was the Cano at bat. It wasn't the one previous to that. Cano was back at the plate that time, and he doesn't get the hit. He gets the bat taken out of his hands because of the caught stealing. We're 3-3 in the fifth now, and oh, with the runner at third is going to be caught coming to the plate there, as that was fielded by Felix Hernandez. And you can't run over a catcher these days, so pretty much just waited for the tag right there. 4-4 in the seventh. Runner on first. Can Jeter do something to get this going, be the spark plug again? Well, that's a solid base hit to right. And it's going to be runners at first and second now as Jeter reaches on the single. Maybe that can get a run home here to get them the lead, as they've got the runner in scoring position now thanks to Jeter's single. So let's see what they can do. Do they get a run out of the deal? Well, it's 6-5 in the ninth now. There were some runs, but Seattle got some as well. Could this be a game-winning shot to right field? Again, he hits it to the fence, but not out of here. That would have won the game. It would have been a walk-off. But instead, it didn't quite make it over the fence. Ah, so close, but couldn't quite do it. Seattle hangs on for the 6-5 victory. Yeah, we'll have to go back and get them the next time out. So as we look at what's happening here, we've got a loss to start the series. We're at 12-14, trying to get to that 500 mark. Seattle's the opposite. They're 14-12. So we play through that and actually into the Tampa Bay series, and we've gotten to 500. Look at that. A win against Seattle on the first, a win against Tampa to start this series off, but we lose the middle game. So we've got Sabathia versus Archer to decide the series with Tampa. Let's see how this goes. It'll be Rays versus Yankees coming up from Yankee Stadium next. Looks like it is going to be a downright beautiful day for baseball. Looks like hardly a cloud in the sky and a nice crowd at Yankee Stadium. As you see, Tampa a couple games ahead of us in the standings. Jeter hitting .333 now. It's trailed off a little bit here as he's struggled a bit. Getting some hits here and there. Obviously, you're seeing the highlights, but he's also had a couple 0 for 4 days. Some games like that. Again, he hits a ball fairly deep to right field, but again, that one's going to be caught right at the line there, and I don't think that made it to the warning track, but he... I don't know. He's going to get some homers out that way out of the short porch. It's not happening yet. I think he's got 3 on the season. Might have had one while we simmed there. They stem the runner, and oh, unlucky there as that ball hangs up for the center fielder to make the catch. He hit it well, but it hung up just too long to be a base hit. And it would have been nice with the runner started too, but it's not to be. So Tampa gets out of their inning. It's 3-2 New York in the bottom of the fifth. Two outs, and Jeter is going to get himself a hit there, taking that one down the left field line past the third baseman. And he's got a single, so it feels good after hitting the ball hard and not getting any results. Here he does get on base and try to work things here. So they extend the lead to 6-2. Jeter up next time, and again, a solid swing. He's putting really good swings on the baseball today, and he'll be rewarded with another single. So two hits for Jeter. Looks like the Yankees might be able to pull this one out here with the 6-2 lead, as Girardi looks pretty satisfied looking on here with what his team's doing today. They do take the game 8-2 and take the series against Tampa 2-1. So that is looking pretty good for New York here as we do another reset, and we are now finally over 500. 16-15, we got a series out in Anaheim coming up next, and then it'll be Milwaukee and then the showdown with the New York Mets. Subway Series coming up. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.